Good afternoon, everyone. I need to step back a little bit. My name is Pastor Chris Doble. I'm here, the pastor at Myerstown Church of the Brethren, and I want to welcome everybody here today, or this afternoon. It's great to have Richland Express back here again for the second year. It's such a blessing to be able to have them here to be able to perform with us here today and be able to worship. And I want to thank everybody for coming out. It's a beautiful Sunday afternoon. A little chilly. It is spring, but it's not snowing, so it's a blessing, right? Amen. So, before we get started, let's bow our heads in a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you. We thank you for giving us this beautiful weather today. And we thank you for giving us the opportunity to be able to come here to worship you. Let today be glorifying to you, all that is said and all that is played. Let your Holy Spirit to come upon us today that it is glorifying to you. We just thank you and praise you for your Son, Jesus, as we're here in the Easter season. And just let us remember why we're here today. It's because of your Son dying on the cross, but not staying dead, but raising again. We just thank you for this opportunity to be able to worship you in this free country. We thank you for the opportunity to be able to be here in this church, to be able to openly be able to worship you. Lord Jesus, we just ask you to be with all the other pastors and other leaders around this world that don't have that quite opportunity. And Lord, we just ask you to continue to be with your nation of Israel. May you just protect them, and we just ask for peace. And we just ask you to continue to guide our paths as we go out to spread your word. We thank you and praise you today. In your loving name, Jesus, amen. Amen. Now I'm going to turn the program over to Richland Express and enjoy.
Everybody have their teeth in?
Oh, don't start. I'm nervous enough. And I do have my own teeth. He does this every time.
And then
people look at my teeth when I'm talking. I have my own. Okay. Lord.
Oh,
it's Bob Carnes, and that's my husband. He's sitting right there. Just tell him.
Thank you all.
The sound man is actually the most important, so if it doesn't go right,
everybody's looking for a ski.
Oh,
excuse for myself, but I am. Right, Bob, do you have something to say?
Yes, dear.
This is a song that is new for us, but I think it's a neat song. I really do. Has such a good message, and it's called The Other Side of Life.
Tears for the love.
miss my dad and mom a lot, so I always dedicate programs to them and love them so much. But we just lost somebody very special. On March 4th, Bob's mom went to be with the Lord in glory. She's going to be 100 May 28th. And she had a good mind, and she lived on her own. And she really was the portrait of a virtuous woman, as my mom was. And I think with her, pleasant words are like a honeycomb, sweet to the soul and health to the bones. A merry heart makes a cheerful countenance. That was Bob's mom. She was not only my mother-in-law, she's my friend. So I'm going to dedicate this song to Annabelle Carnes and also to my Aunt Jamie, who's here today. These are two ladies that like this next song, so I think you'll know it.
With me and he talks with me.
such a blessing to know that when this life is over, for those who know Christ, it's not over. It's eternity. And we can know for sure, for God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Thank you, Lord.
You.
So this song we're going to do, and then we're going to take a quick break. Is that right? Okay. A very short intermission. That way, if you get bored and you want to go to the bathroom, drink some water, we're going to be good.
Also want to say there's a 5 to 10 minute intermission. You gotta use the restroom, but there are plates out there in the gathering place if you would want to leave an offering donated for their mission here that they are doing. Would be greatly appreciated. I don't know if you weren't clapping during that last song. I don't know where you were. My youngest daughter, she loves old country and western music, and if she was here, she would have been up here trying to dance in the aisles. So it was very good. So enjoy your 10 minutes and be back then. And
hey, Andrew, we're going to help them sing a song, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
That's a great song.
Page 302 and then.
Grace, she's once again negotiating a tough thing.
to say no.
Thank you. While everybody's making their way to their seat, Richland Express was formed in 2022 by a haphazard garage concert that we held for Heather's Uncle Nick in our garage. And it took off from there. And the mandolin player, and I'll get into introducing everybody here. But the mandolin player is Mr. Keith Cupp.
Yay!
The lovely banjo player, side of him to his right, is my wife and the warden, Heather Mountain Barnes. To Keith's left is the third Melvin daughter, Arnetta Melvin. No, Art Melvin, youngest of the three. On the big bass there is Brunwyn Melvin.
Yep.
And the pianist and our backup vocalist is Miss Brenda Krause. I don't know where Brenda got there, maybe she quit. But this is Richland Express, and we've been playing a couple, for 3 years. These guys have been playing together for about 3 years. Heather, Rowan, and Arne actually take music lessons from Keith, who still has his own studio. And Keith is our trophy wife, if you didn't know that already. But, you know, we're certainly thankful that we can be here today. The main, the primary reason that we're here and this band was formed is to glorify the name of Jesus Christ. And we just thank God for the opportunity that we can provide you with this ministry and hoping that we can point someone to Christ in this day and knowing full well that he gets all the glory, not us. And again, we thank you all for being here and thank you for being so patient with us. Thank you.
Off with a little bit of a medley, and so if you know the song, just sing it with it. It's about a 3-minute medley, but please sing. It drowns me out. I would love that.
Thank you.
anybody over 65?
Triple three? Oh.
By the late great Earl Strokes. I don't know if any Strokes is, he's the king of the banjo players, and we today call her Mrs. Earl Strokes. So we're gonna get her to play one of the most famous banjo tunes in the world. It's called The Foggy Mountain Breakdown.
Thank you.
Okay.
You want to introduce that?
No, you can introduce it. I don't think I will.
Okay. Well, normally Orange Blossom Special is done with a fiddle.
Oh, yeah.
But we don't have a fiddle, so I wanted a fiddle. But anyway, when he plays, whatever he plays is amazing. He's very humble, but I don't care. He's wonderful. Yes. He's just a tremendous musician, and I'm so appreciative that he plays with us. Thank you so much.
Well, we'll try this for you. Since we don't have a fiddle and we can't really do it correctly, we thought we'd kind of do a cheating version of it with a mandolin. If that's all right, if you'll sit through it, you'll play it too. She's even going to take a turn on a banjo.
Well, have mercy.
Jimmy Norton would call it a banjo. This is the Orange Blossom Special, if you'll kick it off for me. Thank you, folks.
appreciate it. Wasn't bad for an amateur.
That's why we call it a Kinami.
It'll be all right. It's been falling before.
He does all sorts of stuff, but I tell you, I'm... No, thanks a lot, Keith. I really appreciate it. He was a very big help when I lost my dad and then my mom. You know, that was a very difficult period of time. And there were times I'd go over there and I'd just sit there and talk. I didn't even want to get the banjo out or the, you know, but he was such a blessing to me. And I guess what I'm trying to say is when people are hurting, listen to them. Let them talk. Just listen to them. Life can throw you a curveball. And so I thank God for people that listen and offer an encouraging word. So having said that, this next song is a great song. It's called Free Men on a Mountain. And I love this song. It tells you that no matter what we've done, no matter all the mistakes we've made, when we put our faith in a perfect Savior, He forgives us. It doesn't have to be a long prayer. He knows our heart. And I love when the one thief on the cross said to Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. And Jesus said to him, verily I say unto thee, thou shalt be with me today in paradise. I'm so grateful for that. So, thank you. So that's what this song means to me. Psalm 104:4 says, "Who maketh his angels spirits, his ministers a flaming fire." And are they not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation? So that's what this song to me means. And I do believe that when we pass on, I believe we are already going sun, moon, and stars forgot. Upward I fly. Still all my song shall be nearer my God to thee. Nearer my God to thee. Nearer to thee.
Shelter in
These verses tell a story. They tell us stories.
Oh,
that song means so much to me because we were with my mom when she passed away. We got to see her take her last breath. Excuse me, my voice. But it wasn't so with my dad, and that haunted me. It really, I was very upset about that, that I wasn't there when he took his last breath, and I finally had to say, Heather, a pastor once, nothing you can do, should have done, ought to have done, would have altered when you come into this earth and when you leave this earth. So I had to give it to the Lord, even though I know the scriptures. I'm like, Lord, it's yours, he's yours. And you escorted him into your arms. And so I thank God for that. The scriptures keep giving us food, doesn't it? You know, so anyway.
I didn't fall asleep.
I don't know about that. I don't know about that. Way to make the mood not good. Whatever. I love you anyway. I do.
There's a lighthouse on a hillside that overlooks life's sea. When I'm tossed, it sends out light that I might see, and the light that shines in darkness will safely lead me o'er. If it wasn't for the lighthouse, my ship would be no more, and I thank God for the lighthouse. I owe my life to him. Jesus is the lighthouse, and from the rocks of sin he has shone. Oh.
this song and then the final song. So in case anyone's saying, huh, are they soon done? But anyway, this song.
I was just thinking the same.
Were you? Well, I have to take a little drink of water, okay? This song we want to do for you, the audience, and we so much appreciate when you come out to hear us. Thank you so much. And this song is called If We Never Meet Again, This Side of Heaven. You know, we never know when the last time is that we will see somebody. And that's hard, you know. I didn't know the last time I was with his mom that that would be it, you know. So this song is for all of you. We love you all so much, and we get strength from all of you. And before I forget this, I do want to say to George and Carol Klein and her daughter, how much their ministry and song has meant so much to so many people through the years. So I'm very blessed. Thank you. You've been a blessing. You've been a blessing to so many people, guys, so many. City.
was not my fault.
No, it wasn't. You had some flub-ups too. But yeah. Anyway, that's okay. I practice so much, and I always am the one that makes mistakes. Now, I need to give that to
you. That's all right, honey. I already called the order in for Prevagen. You get a discount over 65.
Okay, well, that's all right. So, anyway, God bless all of you. If we never meet again this side of heaven, I will meet you on that beautiful shore. Amen. This last song is a song that we love to do, and we love to honor those who have served in our armed forces. And so if anybody has served in our armed forces, if you could stand, that we may honor you. Say, hey, thank you so much for your service. So proud to be an American, live in the greatest country. So God bless all of you. Thank you for being here. Okay.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my family and my wife. I thank my God above to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from the sea to shining sea,
from Detroit on down to Houston, from New York to LA.
I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Richland Express.
Can we get another round of applause for them? You know, singing that song made us feel as we are very blessed to live in a country that we're able to worship openly and freely to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I think there's so many people out in this world that don't have that freedom as we do. So I continue to urge you and to encourage you to pray. Pray for the people that are in persecution. Pray for the pastors and the people that are there fighting for their freedom to be able to worship their God freely. And let's continue to pray for peace. Continue to pray for peace for us, for here in this country, and also for Israel and what's going on over there. But also we need to stand up and stand strong on the Word of God. And believe that this is all possible because just what we are celebrating this coming week is Easter. Is because of our Lord and Savior that God decided to come here, down to this earth, not because he had to, but because he wanted to, because he had grace for each one of us here. And that he loved every one of us enough to send his son Jesus to die on the cross, but didn't stay dead, that rose again on that third day. And that is why we have the freedom and the privilege to be able to go out and share the gospel. And just as this group here, the Richland Express, said many times, is we're here to serve and worship our Lord and Savior. So let's bow our heads in a word of prayer before we go. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you. We thank you today for all of your many blessings that you have given us. We thank you for our free country. We can come here to worship you openly and freely. But God, we know there's so many people in this world that are facing persecution. We just ask you to watch over them and give them the strength. Give them your joy. Give them your peace today. And may you just lift us up here that we can go out and be bold in your name. That we have a job to do to go out and tell people about you, Jesus. And we just thank you for this opportunity. And we thank you for everything that you bless us with here today. May you just put a hedge of protection over every one of his traveling mercies today. And may we just go out to honor and glorify you in all that we have done. We thank you and we praise you. In your loving son's name, amen.
Amen.
Thanks again for coming out today. And remember, there are offering plates out there if you would feel led to bless this group. Thank you very much and have a safe day.